As for potential power outages, both National Grid and NYSEG are getting ready for what's likely going to be a busy weekend for them. But after being criticized for its response to last week's storm, is NYSEG doing anything differently to keep customers in the loop this time? 200 Side's Erica Brecker gets answers.
Ice, wind, and rain could really make a mess.
With that in mind, we've mobilized around 1,300 people across the state, including approximately 400 here locally.
So far today alone, several meetings have been held, planning meetings. We have already ready crews. Many crews came in today with their bags packed.
Both National Grid and NYSEG are trying to work ahead of the clock so they can respond quickly. Some of the same lines just repaired last week could potentially be compromised again. So what is it about ice that can cause so much damage?
Ice will add weight to tree limbs or power lines. And when you couple that with strong winds, those can easily, they're more susceptible to toppling.
In western New York, a spokesperson for NYSEG says the company is particularly focused on Lancaster and Lockport.
So we have people who are manned, ready to go in all of those areas.
Both utility companies, NYSEG in particular, were criticized last week by customers for the length of time that power restoration times only said, quote, assessing, rather than an actual time estimation. We asked each to explain it. NYSEG dodged answering the question twice.
Well, right now we're focused on preparing for this storm.
National Grid, however, did offer an explanation.
What can you say to viewers who felt that that wasn't enough of an answer for them?
Well, we have crews that need to go out and find out what exactly is damaged. There's transmission lines, there's distribution lines, there's lines that come from your home out to the street. And it sometimes just takes time in order to do that.
And the anticipated weather is already responsible for some precautionary changes. The city of Buffalo has canceled a shredding event that it was going to host this weekend. The city of Niagara Falls has already issued a travel advisory, meaning don't drive if you don't have to. And Erie County's executive put out a PSA reminding people to download the Ready Erie app, which can provide some local emergency information. Reporting live on the rooftop tonight, Erica Brecker, Channel 2 News.